don't understand how it made it worse. It made my lashes disappear.
Hey guys!
Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Teresa Hirado, and today we're gonna be doing a first impressions video. I don't think I've done one of these really recently, but they are one of the most fun ones to film. Also the ones I look forward to the most because I have to hold all these products and not touch them. It's been a struggle. When you see the makeup palette I'm gonna be working with, you're gonna understand. I haven't even been able to swatch it since Christmas. I got this for a Christmas present. It's been a hard one. We're basically just gonna try on a bunch of products, see how I like them. I've never touched these, swatched these. Everything is still in their containers. It's not a 100% full face, but I have most of the products. So we have a good bit to go through today. Drugstore, high-end, a mix. So if you guys are interested in seeing first impressions of, I don't think I can hold them all up, of these products, then keep watching. All right, so we're gonna be smart about this. A lot of times I'll do the face first because I'm impatient and the eyes take a little bit, but I really do think we should do the eyes first just in case there's fallout. It's my first time using the palette. So let's start off with Storybook Cosmetics Mean Girls Burn Book. I'm about, I don't even know how many months late. Is it years now? I don't know. It's been a while. I've been eyeing this bad boy up for quite a bit of time. This is what it looks like. I'm sure you guys have all seen this. You've probably all seen reviews, but this is my first time using it. The mirror as like the witchcraft and wizardry palette. It's like set up the exact same way. So those are the colors. I'm so excited about this color right here. And then this color. A lot of these I'm actually really excited about. Oh my gosh! They're so, like I just, here. We're gonna do like a pretty crazy eye because this is pretty crazy colors. I wanna do a green and pink eye. This is gonna match nothing, but that's why I'm in my sleep shirt. I want it to be super comfortable today. I'm gonna go into So Fetch, which is this orange color. And I've already put a little bit of concealer on my eyes, so I don't think we need to prime or anything. I'm just gonna put it right here. Really, really nice pigmentation, as is the other one. The other one was really, really good too. So what I was envisioning was a pink outside and then on the lid, the green color. So let's see how that goes. Have you ever done that where you're envisioning this great look and when you put the two colors together, it looks like actual crap? That's what I'm worried about. I'm gonna go into Wednesday, which is this pink color that I was talking about. And I'm gonna put that on my crease right here. Ooh, I did put that on the crease right there. I put it on a lot more than I thought I wanted to put it on, but okay. I think I'm gonna cut the crease because I want the green to be super prominent and my eyelids, unfortunately, do not have the real estate for that. I'm gonna go in with a tiny bit more orange and just kind of blend that together. Alrighty, now I'm going to cut the crease. I'm just taking a eyeliner brush and drawing on my new crease line. I'm just filling it in. I'm gonna draw it higher, as always, than my normal lid. Give ourselves the lid of our dreams. There's one. All right, it's green time, and this is called Gruel. It's this color right here, so I'm gonna put that on a flat brush, and we're gonna pack it on top of our concealer. Ooh, yes. I like that it's giving such a beautiful shimmer without needing to wet your brush. I'm gonna try wetting my brush for the other eye and see if that makes a huge difference, because I am having to go in multiple times. But just the fact that it's even showing up on my eye without me wetting my brush is huge. So it's a very, very good shimmer. Or metallic. It's so pretty. Everything I dreamed of. There's one eye. Let's try wetting the brush on this one. I don't really see that much of a difference actually from wetting the brush. This seems to work just as good when it's dry. Like, I don't see any advantage to wetting it. So there's the green. Now what I'm gonna do, like I always do with my cut creases, just cause it's the easiest, I'm gonna take this color that I used right here, which was Wednesday, and I'm just going to put it in the corner and then blend it into the green. I'm gonna take the same orange, which was So Fetch, and Wednesday, the hot pink. I'm gonna do that same color combination under my eye as well. So I'll start with orange. I want that to be a little bit larger, if you know what I mean. Like I want it to go down just a little bit more. Then I'll concentrate the pink towards the lashes. These blend out so easily. Oh my gosh. And then do the same to this eye. Let me do my eyeliner and I'll be right back. The eyeliner is not a new thing. I have the Wet n Wild H2O Proof Eyeliner. I just started using this about a week ago because every single one of my other eyeliners died on me, like dried out. I don't know how, but they all at the same exact time, and I'm scrambling trying to find something because I don't want to have to walk to the store or do anything like that. So I finally found this guy that I had purchased a while ago. I'm liking it a lot so far. From what I can tell, it is waterproof, but I can do a full review or let you guys know in an update on Snapchat or something, but I'm just gonna be using this again. All right, so the eyeliner is done. Now we're gonna move on to mascara. You guys know I usually don't do too many mascara reviews because I don't really use it on the top, I only use it at the bottom. My eyelashes are so straight that they will not curl whatsoever. So even if one of these were to lengthen, my lashes would just be sticking like that. I just feel like it's not very helpful. But I had a mascara hanging out in the wing, so I figured we could just try it real quick. This is the e.l.f. Volumizing and Defining Mascara in Jet Black. I'm a little intrigued because I'm pretty sure this is really, really cheap. This is what the tube looks like, just a big white tube. Open it up. That's what the wand looks like. I'm not a fan of this wand. This wand looks tiny. I shouldn't really go by that, but yeah, I usually like the really, really large ones. I guess we'll just put it on the top for fun because it doesn't matter. So, woo. Now let's do the bottom lashes, which is the most important part. I don't know. That side worked a lot better than the first one. Okay, so let me assess here. Okay, it's gonna be a no for me. What I did initially like about this is that it went on really fast, and I do like that it immediately showed up on my lashes. It made them look blacker. But the problem is my lashes naturally go down more. Somehow this made them straighter. I wouldn't consider this a bad one, but it's just no. It's gonna be a no for me. I'm gonna put on my falsies real quick and then I'll be right back for the next first impression. All right, the lashes are on and I'm still trying to figure out exactly how adding that product made it worse. It made my lashes disappear. If you have different lashes, this might work amazing for you, but just not for me. The next product, I'm gonna be moving on to Face Color Science Even Up 3-in-1 Skin Perfector. SPF 50, water resistant. Ooh, it looks all science-y and scientific looking. Let's open this up. Ooh, I wonder what color it is. Is it like white? I can't imagine this going well if it's white. Oh. Surprisingly, it doesn't smell like anything. I was expecting a sunscreen smell. So that's the color of the cream, and it looks like foundation color. You can see it's a little bit lighter than my skin tone if I was gonna use this as a foundation, but I think it's supposed to be all in, like, all for one. One for all. It says, apply liberally to your face, ensuring even coverage as the first step of your makeup application. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna see if this is going to perfect my skin before I put foundation on it. Oh, okay. Wait. Oh. Trying to shake it. It came out like super runny just right now. I thought it was like a cream, so that's why I was kind of confused. Okay, there we go.
Put it directly on my face.
It smells, oh my god. It smells much more like something when you put it, like rub it around on your face. I'm on the fence between whether it smells good or bad. It definitely reminds me of something from art class though. How do I feel about this? Did it do anything to my skin other than make it a little bit lighter? But the smell, I wish I could pinpoint what it is. It kind of, okay, let me try it. Let me zen out here. Picture my childhood. I don't know why eraser is coming into my head, but it's not just like a pink eraser. It's almost like one of those specialty erasers that you use to take off chalk or something. Putty eraser. It's like if someone smelled that smell and they thought, you know what, I want this in a lotion, so we have to transform it just a bit, then that's what this smells like. Because it's not awful. It's not just like the eraser. It prettied up a little bit more. I mean, I guess personal preference, what's just worse, this or sunscreen, because that doesn't smell too great either. So let's really look at this. What I can say is that you see how it's kind of really hard to rub in? I did find that on my cheeks as well. You really have to work it in there for it to completely absorb. Probably need a lot less than what I just put on my face. Actually is very reminiscent of that color changing foundation that I tried not too long ago, although the consistency and the feel that it leaves me with is much better. Somewhat better, actually. Now that I'm feeling my face, it's somewhat better. Positives are, of course, that regular facial sunscreen, especially SPF 50, it looks absolutely horrendous, smells bad, it doesn't really soak in, and a lot of times it can make you break out, have skin issues. That's what it always did to me. I always used to get hives on my face, like little tiny hives all over. So this is meant for your face. I would not use this if I just needed a primer though. They have a powder version that also has a good SPF on it. I love that so much better. Let's move on to foundation, which I don't even know if this is gonna affect the foundation because this is kind of slippery. It's not really soaking in as much as I wanted it to. But whatever, that's what we're here for. We're just trying stuff out. I have here the Full Spectrum Covergirl Foundation Matte Ambition. So I just got this in PR. I'm gonna do a full review on the entire collection, but I figured while we're here, might as well try the foundation. I'm trying to figure out if I'm tan neutral or medium golden, so we're gonna test that out and see what I am. I'm really excited about this foundation because I've tried their other foundation and fell in love. True Blend Matte Made. I love matte foundations. Absolutely loved theirs. So let's hope this is another slam dunk. So I'm gonna do full swatches in the video, but just wanna try. This is tan neutral. This one is medium golden. They're actually very, very different. I don't think on this one. That one looks way too dark. Which one did I decide? I decided on medium golden, right? No, tan neutral. Welcome to my life, guys. I literally just forgot which shade I was. I was holding both in my hand. I'm like, which one am I? We're doing medium golden. Okay. It looks so light on my skin, but then when I blend it out, it's perfect. I don't know why I'm using a brush. I usually use a beauty blender. Let me wet the beauty blender. I'll be right back. I got back from traveling and I brought a brush because I didn't feel like having to get up and wet my beauty blender and carry around a wet beauty blender in my bag. So that's why I've been kind of on the brush train, but I usually don't like to use them because they're very hard to get to like your hairline and stuff. I end up with foundation in my hair. I love this foundation. It covered, okay, so the forehead, you can see I'm having an issue with the primer underneath, like spreading it, but everywhere else looks absolutely amazing. I like this one, not this one, this one. The next item we're gonna be trying is the ColourPop No Filter Concealer. So if you guys saw my video where I was testing out Beauty Guru approved products, I had purchased the foundation sticks that Nicole Concilio had recommended in her videos, and then I got just concealer. That is really odd. It's like separated, which I guess is normal. I guess that's like a normal thing to happen, but usually it's not. I don't know. We mixed it up. We're gonna try it. I don't know if this is the right color, but I gave it a go and picked medium 22. Let's try that. This might be, it's a tad bit light. Ooh, blending out really good. I do like the applicator. The applicator made it super, super easy to draw on where I wanted it to go. And it's a nice undertone for me. It's not too pink at all. I don't see any pink. It gets more of either a neutral or warm color. I can't tell. Once I put the bronzer on, I'll be able to see if that's the right shade. I can't tell if it's a little too light, but I'm gonna put the bronzer on really quick. I don't have a new product for that, but I'll be right back. What do you guys think? Do you think it's too light? I can't decide. I'll be able to see better when I edit this and see what it actually looks like, but I think the concealer looks great. I'm not seeing anything crazy. I just put it on, of course, but I'm not seeing creasing. I'm not seeing it look too patchy or sinking into my fine lines, so. So far, so good. Now we have the powder, which is another ColourPop. This is their No Filter Setting Powder in Translucent. It is tiny. It is this size. This is just a powder from Five Below, but you can see the size difference, and my Dermablend is even larger than this. I'm gonna open it up. Oh, we have one of these little sifters, but this little sticker that I always have trouble pulling off. Well, that wasn't too bad. So let's put a little in here. Okay, it isn't bright white. It's kind of like a little bit beige. This one, this setting powder, is pure white, as you can see. That's white white. This one has a little bit of a color to it, so I'm gonna take a little, put it right there. Ooh, okay. Right in the middle, a little bit here, and then right under here. I always kind of go crazy with the setting powder. I put it almost everywhere, just not like super heavy up here. I just kind of put it a little bit. Now we wait. Okay, now the true test of the powder is how well it kind of brushes off. Well, I tried to say that as I was bringing the brush over my mouth. It looks pretty good. On their website, they do have a deep one and a banana one, and then they have the translucent one. So I wonder what the banana one would have done So I would have gotten that one. It says it's recommended for all skin tones. Because the translucent one, what I'm seeing on my face, it did make the area look a little bit whiter. And I don't mean bright, I mean whiter. I don't know how well you can see it here, but it did a tiny bit. Very, very slight, like I'm being picky. Like it looks really good, but I do think that maybe I'd want to try the banana one as well. But I really did like how this went on. It looks very matte right now. The next product is the Buxom Wanderlust Primer Infused Blush. I actually went to the launch party of this, which was amazing. I'm gonna do a full video of swatches of everything from the Wanderlust collection because I had gotten them at the launch party. But I figured we could try this one real quick in the video. This is Dolly. This is what it looks like. It's a really pretty pinkish kind of color. Primer Infused Blush is an interesting one. Interesting combination. Wow, okay. I just went in for like one more and everything about this look is vibrant. It does blend out really nice though. And this is kind of exactly the color I wanted. Ooh, we're there with the color. I don't need any more. That is really, really nice. That's good that it has like a primer infusion though, because blushes can sometimes like go away throughout the day, especially if you're kind of sweaty a little bit. And you can put makeup setting spray on top, but it's nice that that has it kind of built in. And the color is gorgeous. While we're here really quick, before I do the last product, I'm just gonna add a little bit of highlight on this palette. I'm just gonna take this pink color, the Regina George, which is really funny because I just got the Jeffree Star mystery box and his highlighter was also a pink. Not that this is a highlighter, it's an eyeshadow, but his pink highlighter is called Regina George as well. Maybe I'll take the yellow. Is butter a carb? This palette is my new best friend. There is so many looks that I am thinking of when just looking at the colors in here. All right, and then last but not least, let's take a big drink of water before we do this. It is the lips. Right now I have the Pixi by Petra in Au Naturel. You guys saw my Instagram video, I mixed up my own color. They had given like this kind of kit that you could send in to potentially win, I think it was like a trip to their headquarters or something, and then possibly have your color made into one of their shades in their line. I forgot to send mine in. I made it. You can see what color I made and everything, but I forgot to send it in. But anyway, it was the only time I've tried, I guess, this formula. I think it was the same formula, the one that I mixed up, but I've never actually tried it from the tube, liquid lipstick, so I am excited. A little scared again because of my lips, very dry, but we're gonna give it a go. I'm excited about the color. The Doe Foot is one of those larger ones that have kind of the triangle look to them.
Here goes nothing.
Oh wow. And that is the lipstick. I love this shade. I think the shade is a really pretty like orange kind of color, and let me tell you, this stuff smells like an orange popsicle. Let me double check. Or creamsicle. Smells so good. And what's really cool about this particular applicator, it's not bolted in like one direction, it moves when you move, so that's really cool. So it helps you kind of get the angles of your lips just right. Of course, my lips, like I say, in a matte, you can definitely see all the stuff in my lips, but it's not overly drying. It doesn't feel drying on my lips. I forget which one it was that I tried, but it was a liquid lipstick that I put it on, and when I smiled, it felt like my lips were just cracking apart. It was the weirdest feeling, and I hated it. So this does not feel like that at all, and it looks really, really good. It definitely dried down all the way. No transfer. I think that one was a slam dunk. What did you guys think about the products that we tried today? I really liked the blush, the lips. Of course, the eyeshadow palette was amazing. I can't wait to do so many more looks with that. The foundation was really, really good too. The setting powder I actually did like. I'm just curious about the banana. I wanna try that one so bad now. The concealer I actually did not mind either. At first it was like a weird thing when I was looking in the tube and it kind of looked dried out, but maybe it just needed a good shake. Sometimes things settle. I think it looks really good on. So the two things that I didn't like were the mascara, and I don't wanna say I didn't like it, but the primer was something that I really would need to want. So maybe if I wanted a sunscreen that I knew I could put on my face, that it wouldn't do anything weird, I would use that, but definitely not just as a normal primer in my day-to-day life. I absolutely love the end result of this makeup look. I think it turned out really well. Why am I whispering? So let me know what you guys think. Which were your favorite products? Are there any products that you want to go out and purchase? Any that you don't want to go out and purchase? Any that you've tried, maybe you've had a similar or a different result, I'd be interested to hear about that. And definitely let me know any other products you want me to try out in a future first impression. If you have not subscribed, definitely subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you can be alerted when I put on a new video. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!